This is West Run, a slow-moving creek lined with honeysuckle and wild rose that meanders through the mountains of West Virginia. The tranquil scene near Morgantown is almost picture perfect, but look carefully at the color of the sediment that lies beneath the water. Fire orange on one side, milky white on the other. This is not a healthy creek. In fact, water quality experts say this creek is dead. What killed West Run is acid mine drainage from coal mines. Acidic mine water is tainting many streams in the heart of West Virginia's coal country. But this isn't just a story about drainage and pollution. It's also about recovery in more ways than one.
And acid mine drainage is something we've been trying to make go away for a very long time here. And the Monongahela River that you crossed on the way into town here used to be orange only in the early 1970s. It's now a fishery, and the streams that feed into it, which were also orange to a large extent, we're sort of moving the clean water zone and all these streams way up toward the headwaters or where the mines actually are.
That was Paul Zimkavich, director of the Water Research Institute at West Virginia University, who tells us improved oversight and treatment technology are helping restore water quality. Over the past several decades, the state of West Virginia has started treating the discharge from many shuttered coal mines, such as the Omega mine shown here. And active mines are required to treat acid mine drainage with lime or some other neutralizing agent to prevent streams and rivers from ending up like West Run. If left untreated, acid mine drainage contaminates water, giving it a rust taste, harming aquatic life and corroding infrastructure, such as bridges. It's also responsible for the stream discoloration you saw earlier. Acid mine drainage occurs from mines when coal contains a lot of pyrite or iron sulfide. The pyrite reacts with oxygen and water to form sulfuric acid and iron 2, or ferrous iron. Between pH 3 and 3.5, iron 2 reacts with oxygen and hydroxides to form iron 3, ferric hydroxides, which precipitate as orange solids. Acid mine drainage also typically contains high levels of aluminum and manganese, which precipitate as hydroxides. Aluminum hydroxide is responsible for the milky white sediment in West Run. Regulations require active mines to treat acid mine drainage at its source.
So in order to take that water, treat it, and then make that water fit for discharge to the waters of the United States under the Clean Water Act, those metals need to be removed and the pH has to be brought up to a range between 6 and 9.
Treating acid mine drainage leaves behind tons of sludge that contains mostly iron, aluminum, and manganese hydroxides. The sludge is typically sun-dried in large ponds or in dewatering containers such as 10K geotubes shown here. Once dried, the sludge is often disposed of underground. Disposing of this sludge contributes to about half of the costs associated with treating acid mine drainage, and that is a lot of money. West Virginia spends millions of dollars each year combating acid mine drainage. Researchers like Zimkavich are pioneering another recovery effort to help bring those costs down. At WVU, he's leading a project to recover valuable rare earth elements from the sludge, which could help lower treatment costs for both the coal industry and the state of West Virginia. Rare earth elements are used in many products, including cell phones, TV screens, wind turbines, defense aircraft, and satellites used for national security. Although it's too early to tell whether WVU's extraction process will be economical, the technical performance looks promising. Zimkavich knew from data collected in the 1990s by the U.S. Geological Survey that acid mine drainage entering treatment plants contains rare earth elements, but the water leaving the plants does not. He suspected that the rare earth elements precipitate into the sludge during treatment, and he was right.
Took some samples, analyzed them, and sure enough, the elemental rare earth concentration in these sludges was much higher than you would get in the raw acid mine drainage, the untreated acid mine drainage. And one of the things we found out is that the concentration factor is overall about 2,600.
The question then became how to recover the valuable rare earths from the sludge material. The WVU team is still optimizing that process, but here's the gist of it. The first step is to digest the sludge in a tank of acid, such as sulfuric acid.
Based on what we've seen in the laboratory, we can get something like 90-95% of all of the rare earths out of sludge by adjusting the pH down to about 1.
Next, the acid solution, called the pregnant leach solution, enters an array of 100 columns called mixer settlers. The first set of vessels contain an organic phase, such as kerosene, and an extractant, which binds to rare earth elements. This forms an emulsion containing rare earths in the organic phase. After removing unwanted metals from the aqueous phase, the researchers use a strong acid to get the rare earths back into the aqueous phase at a higher concentration than they started with. The team then raises the pH, allowing the rare earths to precipitate as a purified sludge.
Not all rare earth elements are created equal, and some of them are very valuable and some of them are not. So one of the things we'll be doing in this process is optimizing recovery of the valuable rare earth elements and not waste time and money extracting things that aren't very useful.
Rare earths are needed for many modern day commodities, and the U.S. is keen to have a ready source of them at hand for national security reasons.
As high-tech industries have grown, the rare earth elements demand has grown with it. Unfortunately, we don't have a domestic supply of rare earth elements, so we import virtually all of our rare earth elements from the People's Republic of China. And so that's where it becomes a matter of domestic importance.
The U.S. Department of Energy agrees that it is critically important for national security to have a domestic source of rare earth elements, especially in light of the current trade war between the U.S. and China. You can read more about this work and other rare earth recovery efforts from coal-related products in my July 9th cover story for CNEN.